Hypersonic weapons, traveling at speeds over Mach 5, are considered unstoppable because conventional defense systems, which rely on interceptor missiles, cannot effectively counter them. This has led major military powers to heavily invest in hypersonic technology to bypass enemy defenses and strike deep into enemy territory. Addressing the threat of hypersonic weapons requires the development of unconventional defense systems. Laser defense systems are believed to have the potential to intercept various aerial threats, including hypersonic weapons. While some laser air defense systems are in use today, a high-power operational system specifically designed to counter hypersonic weapons or aircraft has not yet been developed. How do laser beams destroy airborne threats? How much laser power is needed to target aircraft, hypersonic weapons, and satellites? What major challenges arise in developing powerful laser defense systems? High-powered lasers emit a concentrated beam of energy that generates intense heat upon striking a target, leading to damage or destruction. To destroy a target, the laser must deliver enough energy to surpass the material's damage threshold. The power required to neutralize targets such as aircraft, missiles, or satellites primarily depends on factors like the target's material, size, and vulnerability. Laser power is measured in watts per square centimeter. A laser with 50 to 100 kilowatts of power can disable aircraft sensors, ignite fuel, or damage critical components. A laser exceeding 300 kilowatts can destroy an aircraft by penetrating its reinforced materials. A 100 to 200 kilowatt laser can destroy small missiles by damaging their guidance systems or igniting their warheads. Lasers with 300 to 500 kilowatts can neutralize ballistic and hypersonic missiles. Destroying satellites requires immense power. A 500 to 700 kilowatt laser can damage solar panels, sensors, or electronic components of small, low Earth orbit satellites. These laser power levels represent the ideal requirements for neutralizing such targets without considering the distance and atmospheric factors. An operational ground-based laser defense system must be significantly more powerful to deliver an effective beam to such target. Lasers lose significant energy as they travel through the atmosphere due to factors like humidity, dust, and other particles that cause scattering and absorption. Even under ideal conditions, the laser effectiveness decreases with distance due to beam divergence. Lasers lose 1 to 3% of their energy per kilometer in a dry, clean environment. However, in humid, foggy, smoky, cloudy, or rainy conditions, energy loss increases significantly, ranging from 5% to 60% per kilometer. Under ideal conditions, a 1 megawatt laser can destroy any aircraft or missile at a distance of 10 to 20 kilometers almost instantaneously. Additionally, a 1 megawatt laser remains effective against aircraft and missiles at distances of up to 100 kilometers in ideal conditions, though the time required for destruction increases with distance due to reduced power density. A 1 megawatt laser is also capable of damaging or disabling satellites in low Earth orbit. In worst environmental conditions, even a 1 megawatt laser is ineffective and unable to destroy aircraft, missiles, or satellites. To destroy aircraft, missiles, and satellites in such adverse conditions, a significantly more powerful laser is required. If a 1 megawatt laser delivers only around 10% of its power to the aircraft due to environmental losses, the effective power becomes insufficient to destroy it. To overcome these losses, a 10-megawatt laser would ensure that approximately 1 megawatt reaches the target, which is sufficient to destroy an aircraft. For a missile to receive 100 to 500 kilowatts of power at the target, a 50-megawatt laser would be necessary, assuming 99% power losses over a distance of 50 kilometers. For low Earth orbit, up to 500 kilometers, a 100-megawatt laser would be required to ensure enough power to damage or destroy critical satellite components after accounting for atmospheric losses. For geostationary orbit, up to 36,000 kilometers, a 1-gigawatt laser would be needed to deliver a meaningful amount of energy to the target, compensating for the massive losses over such distances. Such powerful lasers have not yet been developed. Currently operational systems, such as the U.S. Navy's laser weapon system and the Israeli Iron Beam, operate in the range of tens to hundreds of kilowatts. These systems are primarily effective at neutralizing drones and smaller projectiles with precision. Countries like the United States, China, and Russia are actively working on developing next-generation laser systems with power levels exceeding the megawatt range. These advancements aim to counter larger and faster targets, such as hypersonic missiles. While firing a laser is relatively inexpensive, the development and maintenance of the technology remain costly. High-energy lasers generate significant heat, requiring sophisticated cooling systems to prevent overheating. They also demand substantial and stable power sources, which makes their deployment on mobile or small platforms particularly challenging.